This video is going to show usage of various Navmesh attributes. It will also try to show some examples of places where they are usually used. I will show the attributes in the same order as in Navmesh console command reference from Valve developer community. If you have any problems, go there. Just be aware that there are some commands that only work with Left 4 Dead. To know which ones work in CSGO or are not useful in CSGO, look in the description of this video. And this tutorial is going to apply to CSGO and CSS. First off, let's start with basics. To apply an attribute, simply aim at an area or add the tiles you want to select at set, and then execute the command that gives them a certain attribute. To remove them, just execute the same command you've used to add an attribute. Also, this time bot Alfred is going to help me show how these attributes work. We will show them in a bit.
Thanks to Bez for helping me to make this video, and bot Alfred for being the hero that we needed.
So, let's get right into it. Unlike Left 4 Dead, in CSGO players don't crouch automatically, so this attribute must be used around areas that can be traversed only by crouching. In theory, it toggles the don't avoid obstacles flag used by the AI system. I don't exactly know what an obstacle for CSGO next bot is, as it doesn't mean tiles marked with obstacle top attribute. The behavior I've noticed is more precise and direct movement. Let's look at three examples of how NextBot is going to traverse Dust to Long with this attribute. Without enough precise, bot is not going to use fastest path every time. Sometimes he may go between tiles, especially if he hears gunshots around the corner. With enough precise, he's going to take approximately the same path every time, even if he suspects enemy around the corner. You might think that forcing them to take the shortest path every time is a good thing, but in practice, using enough precise too much might cause unrealistic movement and make bot a lot more predictable on your map. Use it only in really small spaces, especially if bots risk falling off a ledge, or with Left 4 Dead style jump solution that I will cover in a second. By default, Nav Generate uses this style to mark areas where bots need to jump. However, there is a way better solution to make an area where bots need to jump than this buggy mess. I call it Left 4 Dead style jump. And as you can expect, it means that you should replace nav jump areas by Left 4 Dead style connection jump. It also makes one-way connections impossible, like here on Santorini. Using a nav jump tile would make bots jump up but also jump down while we want them to only jump up and walk down. That's where Left 4 Dead jump solution shines the most. While it doesn't make them jump instantly, causing them to sometimes bump into an obstacle before jumping, it allows for a one-way jumps and doesn't require them to traverse the whole jump in the same way every time for it to count as traversed. And as I mentioned earlier, Nav Precise is really useful with this to make sure that the bots run directly at the place where they need to jump, to make sure they will not try to jump against the wall or something. If your bots are still jumping down, even if you've made a one-way jump with Left 4 Dead solution, that probably means they update to the bottom tile too fast. If you want more explanation on this, you can visit Perfect Navmesh Steam Group and Red Santorini Cafe jump discussion. However, I will try to give you a shorter version of this. When bots are walking over a tile, they get attributes from it. They can hold attributes from only one tile at a time. If you have a connection that leaves them walking over space without tiles, they will just keep attributes from the one they were standing on. You might ask, when they are getting those attributes? They get them from tiles directly under them, even if they are not directly standing on them. In case of Santorini, a precise tile was too close to ledge, making bots switch their attributes from no jump to precise. And that basically meant that they are allowed to jump the moment that tile is under them. To fix this, just make sure that there are no new tiles under them as long as they are standing on an object they need to walk off. You can fix it by either splitting an area and removing part that is too close to the ledge, or if the removed area is going to make too much free space, you can use Nav Shift tool to shift an area before clipping. It makes sure that bots never jump on the tile that this attribute is applied to. Since usually bots do not benefit in any way by jumping during a fight, I usually select all the tiles by using Nav Flute Select and then applying this attribute everywhere. Then I'm just removing it in places where bots need to jump. This tells bots that
it's time to stop
for a second when entering this tile, useful to align a bot for a tricky jump if they keep missing it, or to align them before crossing a path where they risk falling off a ledge and taking damage. Navwalk tells bots that they need to traverse that area by walking, and Navrun tells them that they need to traverse this area by running, in theory. In practice, however, it seems like those two attributes are completely broken, as I could get them to work only on spawn and only under certain conditions, like having spawns of both teams at certain distance from each other, etc. I don't know if the way they work now is intentional, but either way, Valve, please fix. Makes an area a lot more dangerous for bots to cross. This is very useful for areas that are very risky, but still possible to go to, like city spawn stairs on Sparity or suicide on Dust. Just be aware that sometimes they might not make a big difference, especially if you're trying to use it as a way to discourage using something like a contact point, for an example blocking off middle or a path to a bombsite. In theory, it marks an area with area is transient and may become blocked flag. In practice, in all scenarios I've used it in, it didn't work. Doesn't matter if it was blocked by a wall or the ground disappeared, bots still tried to go through it. Valve, please fix. Nav Don't Hide makes sure that hiding spots do not generate on an area it's been added to. You might be wondering, what tiles are capable of generating hiding spots? Basically, all tiles that have at least one corner that's not connected to any other area. And by connected, I don't mean touching. Two areas can be the same size along the edge and really close to each other, but as long as they're not connected and have at least one free corner, they can generate hiding spots. This attribute makes sure that bots stand while hiding, but only while hiding. It's useful for hiding spots behind crates or other stuff. However, it's not good to place them everywhere you can, because even if you add it, sometimes bots, especially snipers, are going to crouch every time they fire. I generally add it if bots can't see a huge chunk of space when crouching or when they are visible when both standing and crouching while they can't see the enemy dick, because they will always aim at it. As always, if you have any trouble, visit the article on navigation editing I will leave in the description or ask on Perfect Navmesh Steam group. Have fun!